Hello students, we were studying the first chapter of history, how, when and where. In this chapter, we have studied several topics in two previous videos. This is the part 3 and it is the last video of this chapter. In this video, we will discuss about surveys become important and what official records do not tell. Just try to understand, in the previous video we discussed about the records kept by administration, British administratives, and today we'll study about surveys become important. Before starting this topic, we should know what is survey. What do you understand by survey? Survey, it is a study of the opinions and behaviors, etc. of group of people. And examining land, topography, soil, etc. means this is known as survey. It is one kind of study. So let's read. The practice of surveying also became common under the colonial administration. Why? Why the British focused on surveying the different things? Because the British believed, they used to think that a country had to be properly known before it could be effectively administered. If we know everything about the country, more and more knowledge we have to collect, if we get it, then easily we would be able to administer that country, right? So the British focused on survey. By the early 19th century, detailed surveys were being carried out to map the entire country. In the villages, revenue surveys. What do you understand by revenue? That was a part of the production in the fields by the peasants and farmers. They had to pay to the British as like taxes. So it was known as revenue. In Hindi, it is called lagan. So in the villages, revenue surveys were conducted. The effort was to know the topography. What about topography? What kind of land is there? What kind of soil? How much it is fertile? And the flora means the plants, animals, and the local histories, and the cropping pattern means in which season which crops are grown by the peasants and farmers. So all these kinds of facts seen as necessary to know about to administer the region from the end of the 19th century. Censuses operations were held every 10 years, means first census. What do you understand by census? Census is the demographic division of the country. It means it is just like counting the population, quality of people, age groups, etc. Literacy rate, sex ratio, everything is counted in census. So when was first census conducted in India? In 1872. In which year? In 1872, first census conducted in India. But first decadal census, after this census, after every 10 years census was conducted. So it was the first decadal proper census. But first census in India, 1872. These two datas are very important, facts are important, you have to remember. The effort was to know the topography, soil quality, etc. Everything we have discussed. And these prepare detailed records of the number of people in all the provinces of India, noting information on castes, religions and occupations. There were many other surveys, botanical surveys, geological surveys, archaeological surveys and anthropological surveys, forest surveys, etc. All kinds of surveys were conducted. See figure number 5, a custard apple plant, 1770s, botanical gardens and natural history museums established by the British collected plant specimens and information about their uses. Means what kind of plants and species are found in particular area, so that they would feel easiness to use them, and information about their uses. Local artists were asked to draw pictures of these specimens so that they could identify them. Historians are now looking at the way such information was gathered and what this information reveals about the nature of colonialism. So they did here whatever was benefited for the British. Now, after survey, we'll study what official records do not tell. In the previous video, we discussed about administrators' record kept by administration, British administration. And now we'll discuss that the record that was not kept by the offices or by the administrators, and it was not official record. So from this vast corpus of records, we can get to know a lot. But we must remember that these are official records. They tell us how the officials thought and what they were interested in and what they wished to preserve for prosperity. Means you are understanding, students? The officials used to keep the only record that they wanted to keep, right? So it was official record. So by studying this record, we cannot know the reality, right? It is not possible because it is one-sided record. It was kept only by the officials. That was good for them. And these records do not always help us understand what other people in the country felt, means rather than officials, and what lay behind their actions. It means the British people, what they wish to preserve for posterity. Posterity means the for future or for the next generation, whatever, whosoever will study in future, this is posterity. For that, we need to look elsewhere. When we begin to search for these other sources, we find them in plenty, though they are more difficult to get than official records. We have diaries of people, right? Means other sources of information. People used to write their diaries. Accounts of pilgrims, means the people traveled here in India, they wrote something. Autobiographies of important personalities and popular booklets that were sold in the local bazaars. These are another sources, and these sources kept the information that was not available in official records. Getting my point? So as printing spread, newspapers were published, became available in the market, and issues were debated in public. Leaders and reformers wrote to spread their ideas. Poets, novelists wrote to express their feelings. All these sources, however, were produced by those who were literate. Means these sources also have some kind of deficiencies. What kind of deficiencies? For example, we discussed about the official record. Definitely, official record was kept by the British people, administratives, right? So we cannot understand everything about studying the sources kept by British. But these sources also are not ultimate. Why? Because these were written by the literate people, those who people were educated. From these, we will not be able to understand how history was experienced and lived by the tribals, because they did not write the experience of tribal people. They did not write the experience of peasants, workers, etc. So peasants, workers in the mines, or the poor on the streets, getting to know their lives is a more difficult task. So in this way, these sources also have some kind of deficiencies. Let's see this activity. Look at source 1 and source 2. Differences in the nature of reporting. Explain what you observe. See, in the previous video, we discussed about source 1. In source 1, it was explained by the British people how they controlled the strike in the Royal Navy of India. And in source 2, now we'll study about source 2. See this. Source 2. This is source 2. Not fit for human consumption. This is about newspapers provide accounts of the movements in different parts of the country. So this knowledge of movements was not explained in the official records, not kept by officials. Here is a report of a police strike in 1946. More than 2000 policemen in Delhi refused to take their food on Thursday morning as a protest against their low salaries and the bad quality of food supplied to them from police lines kitchen. So this was a strike by the police people. As the news spread to the other police stations, the men there also refused to take food. One of the strikers said, "The food supplied to us from the police lines kitchen is not fit for human consumption. Even cattle would not eat, and chapatis and dal which we have to eat." So it means this was the source from Hindustan Times, 22 March 1946. So in this way, this was the record found in the newspaper. But this same thing is not kept by officials. It is not found in anywhere in the British official record. So in this way, these kinds of knowledge or information we can get from other sources. See here about survey figure 6, mapping and survey operations in progress in Bengal, a drawing by James Prinsep. This was prepared by painter James Prinsep in 1832. Note how all the instruments that were used in surveys, these are the instruments, right, used in surveys, are placed in the foreground to emphasize the scientific nature of the project. So this project is of scientific nature, and it was considered important by the British, as we have discussed that how surveys became very important. Let's see figure 7, the rebels of 1857. This painting made by the British, images need to be carefully studied for the project, the viewpoint of those who create them. This image can be found in several illustrated books produced by the British. After 1857 rebellion, the caption at the bottom says that mutinous sepoys share the loot. It means they were looting the different kinds of commodities. In British representations, the rebels appear as greedy people, but it is not fact, it is not reality, but British depicted this vicious and brutal. You will read about the rebellion in chapter 5. So this kind of prediction was presented by the British government or British administrators. So it was not reality. So just we have discussed about the sources found in officials and non-officials. So dear students, this was the chapter, end of the chapter. I hope that you understood all the topics of this chapter. If you have any doubt, you can ask me by writing in the comment box. Okay, just revise the chapter again. Thank you. Have a nice day.